Ryan Little.
Listen.
Yo, this is your boy James over at Expecto Girl, bringing you guys the latest and greatest in Wizards Unite content. And tonight, your boy is actually out and about collecting spell energy, getting ready for the second adversaries event for the month of February. But we are here to provide you guys the specific details for the upcoming February Community Day. And just like with every Community Day, we got an awesome page with the possibility of prestiging if you haven't already. And if you have already prestiged this specific page, this is great chances for field guides, ministry manuals, and with the guaranteed fragments in force 4 or higher, great chances to utilize your SOS skills, whether it's getting gold gifts, whether it's getting spell books, or just XP via your treasure trunk. So that is what your boy is hyped about. So if you guys are excited about this event and other events in Wizards Unite, consider subscribing to Expecto Go. Here you'll be getting all the information from Harry Potter Wizards Unite dev team. So yo, hit that subscribe and notification bell. But yo, without further ado, let's dive right on into the details. All right, so early access to this information is provided by WB and Niantic, so shout out. And of course, the infographics are courtesy of the man, the myth, the legend, Orange Wizard. So the February Community Day starts February 20th, midnight, your local time, wherever you are in the world, that's when it will start. And it's going to be 24 hours per usual. And per usual, we will have this event featuring a specific page in your registry. This specific page will be under the Mysterious Artifacts page, particularly the Room of Requirement 3. And you will have a chance to get all those foundables via the tonic, via the portkey, and wizarding challenge with the Mysterious Artifacts runestones. Via the tonic boosted, you will see on your map the Marauder's Map, Omnioculars, Mad-Eye Moody's Eye, and the Time Turner, which are very good foundables, particularly Omnioculars and the Time Turners. Yo, that's going to be very clutch. And again, a chance to prestige your page if you have not done so already. So that's how you can get those four foundables via the tonic for trace detection. Then via the portkey, the special Community Day 1 kilometer portkey, you will be rewarded, guaranteed, the cursed opal necklace. And via the Mysterious Artifacts runestones, it will be guaranteeing you Sirius Flying Motorbike. Now, I can't remember if this is going to be in any chamber. I know we usually have guaranteed force 4 or higher fragments rewards. So if I find out before this video is released, I'll just post it in the comment section below. Also during this window, the features going to be seeing will be reduced brew times for the tonic for trace detection, 1 hour. And then with the master notes, it's going to be a half hour in the normal cauldron and 27 minutes in the rental cauldron. Make sure you give yourself some time if you're trying to start at midnight. Maybe start at 12:04 just to be safe, all right? So that's going to be featured during this event. I'm assuming we'll also be getting Force 4 or higher guaranteed fortress fragments using any runestone, along with the spell energy like we normally get. Also, like we normally get the increased wizarding XP and challenge XP during this event. So, yo, always clutch, always a good time. Yo, it's going to be fun. Moving on to the task for Community Day for the month of February. And for your slate of tasks during this Community Day window, we have use master notes 4 times. You'll be rewarded a silver key. Then return 15 Omnioculars, you get 6 snowdrops. Return 8 Hermione's Time Turners, you'll get 2 strong stimulus potions. Going down, defeat 20 foes in wizarding challenges, you'll get 2 healing potions. Then collect 7 Sirius Flying Motorbikes, you'll be rewarded 2 potent extimulo potions. Then place 2 Mysterious Artifacts images in it, you'll be rewarded 4 unicorn hairs. Your bonus features or bonus rewards will be 3 data books, 3 spell books, coin XP, and spell energy. Now, quick tips for you guys. Use Master Notes 4 times. Yo, that's pretty cut and dry. You're going to be brewing the tonic anyway. So, yo, easy money. Knock that out via the tonic. Then return 15 Omnioculars, the return 8 Hermione Time Turners. That's going to be very easy to knock out. All you got to do, yo, use the tonic. Is going to be boosting those foundables specifically. And if you're able to go out and about, particularly with the Hermione's Time Turners, you have a great chance at parks and parking lots, just like my suggestion with the adversaries. Yo, the spawn rates have been great if you're able to go out. If you're locked in and got snow, it can't go anywhere, or via the virus, yo, stay at home and utilize the tonic. The tuning should be very good for you guys. Going down, defeat 20 foes in Wizarding Challenges. Yo, hit us up. Expecto Goat Discord, link in the will be in the description. You'll be able to link up with us 9 a.m. Eastern Time and 2 p.m. Eastern Time are the times when we have our night bus sessions. You'll be able to communicate, meet some fellow witches and wizards, and have some fun along the way. If you're riding solo, yo, you can do Ruins Chambers honestly and do that 10 times. They average about 2 foes per chamber, and you'll be done with that specifically, like, without using any spell energy. And don't forget, you'll be rewarded spell energy once you complete any of the chambers anyway. So yo, you'll be good. Then going down, collect 7 serious flying motorbikes, use mysterious artifacts runestone. Again, we'll find out if it'll work in the lower chambers, but particularly force 4 and higher, we already know it's going to be guaranteed. So yo, link up with some cats, it'll be fine. But this one, place 2 mysterious artifact images any. The best bet for this one will be the Hermione's Time Turner foundable. That's going to be about 10 fragments you need to place on a gold page, 7 for a silver, going all the way down. So yo, that's going to be easy money. And if you're able to place these particularly twice before you prestige, that's less work for you to do. So yo, just consider that when trying to knock out this specific task. Now overall, again, do not forget, you have guaranteed fragments, fortress fragments, and force 4 or higher. This is a great chance to work on some pages where you might be close to placing specific fortress fragments, so you can increase your chances of getting gold gifts, spell books, or even XP courtesy of your SOS skills that you've unlocked. I always grind the oddities runestones because I know there's only 2 fragments I have to worry about, and so that's always a good time. You need to collect fragments for a serious flying motorbike. Yo, mysterious artifacts are going to be clutch as well during this event. So yo, it's going to be a good chance to get a lot of stuff and rack up on some field guides and ministry manuals. And last but certainly not least will be your community day bundles, complimentary gift giving you enough ingredients for 1 tonic and some spell energy. Then you have your SOS bundle and your community day bundle. Spend at your own risk. But yo, that is going to be it in regards to the details and tips for the upcoming community day for the month of February and Harry Potter Wizards Unite. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you guys found it informative, helpful, entertaining, or of any use, drop that like. Also, if you have not done so already, consider subscribing to Expecto Go. Here we get all the latest and greatest in Wizards Unite content, gameplay, tips, news, updates, vlogs, and live streams. So if you guys are into that, consider subscribing to Expecto Go and hit that notification bell. Also, check us out on our various forms of social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Discord. So yo, check us out there. Links will be in the description below. We have some birthdays this month for the month of February, and we want to give a special shout out to them. First, we got Christina's, whose birthday was on February 9th. Happy belated birthday to you, Christina. We also have Joshua, who we sang happy birthday to during our Wizarding Wednesday live stream. But again, happy birthday, Josh. We have Bakers, who's coming up on February 20th. I want to give a special shout out to you, Baker. Thank you guys for your continued support, and I hope this brightens your day. But yo, I'm going to get out of here. I'll see you guys in the next video. Until next time.